The views and opinions of this broadcast do not reflect the views and opinions of Armed Media, UNU Productions and its affiliates. Enjoy the show. Tax the rich, feed the poor, tell their own rich no more.
Welcome to Pod Talk, everybody. I'm Jimmy Bell.
I'm Paul Daniels.
I'm Josh Daniels.
And I'm Jeremy Gibbs.
Yeah, there we go. Better note.
So everybody, you're going to have to excuse Paul and Jimmy. They've got a bad case of Freon going on. They've been huffing it all night, so their voices are a little deep.
Yes. Your lack of faith I find disturbing.
So, what do we got, guys?
First subject.
Let's do impeachment because it's the oldest.
Yeah. Nancy Pelosi said that she's going to be sending the articles of impeachment over to the Senate.
Next week.
Soon.
Yeah, all I heard was soon.
And, soon now.
Well, that's because Mitch McConnell first forced her hand. He kept telling her, you know, this is ridiculous. This was...
They have another senator that brought up a bill and saying, let's dismiss all charges for lack of interest.
Yeah, lack of prosecution.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, because every single person kept saying, right, they were all saying, you know, this is a huge state of emergency, it's a huge emergency to the integrity of our election, he's dangerous, you know, this is urgent. And their fucking feet, really, how urgent is it?
He's only dangerous because they can't buy him out.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, he owes nobody.
Well, not only that, though, but they're going to be afraid to be seen the inside of jail cells soon if he gets elected again.
Right. He'll be definitely pushing that Durham report. That should be coming out this summer. So that, like I said, that might go straight into the election.
Right.
He can make somebody accountable, starting with Hillary.
Why does that say that? Sorry, hold on a sec.
Freon.
No, we're good.
Yeah, but I don't know why it went off.
Ah, fuck it. Don't worry about it. Just shut it down. Oh, give out the number, Jimmy.
1-800-508-5431.
And we don't have the phone attached up to this. It wouldn't matter anyways. That fucking piece of shit Mike's not going to hear it.
Well,
you gotta put the fucking.
How about this? Do we have a Facebook page set up?
Jimmy.
For what? Pot Talk.
Yes.
Yeah, it's Pot Talk.
All right, everybody, let's do a little experiment. How about everybody hops on Facebook tonight? If you're listening, go give Pot Talk a like. Or shoot Pot Talk a message if the message option's available, just so we can see who's listening out there.
Well, you're about to find out when nobody calls.
That's all right. I don't give a shit. I don't even care if we're talking to ourselves.
I really should do this, but I never advertise on Facebook or anything and send it out that we're going to be going on live at 8 o'clock tonight.
Well, Jimmy, that's what we got to start doing.
Well, that, like I said, well, we should be doing it during the fucking show.
No, all three of you are fucking computer whizzes. Fucking get together and do something about it. There's my moral outrage for the night.
Hey, your moral outrage is we're a bunch of lazy fucks.
Right?
Why do you think I said you three?
Us three. You can help control. Give us ideas. The juice is flowing.
I'll draw a picture.
Perfect. Be my wife, will ya?
Of course.
I'll bounce ideas off ya.
Well, that's something I can do. You can bounce ideas off me, but I'm not the one that can put it into fucking practice.
That's yeah, no, right. Right, I know.
Mr. Cooch responded to me. He's going to do some shows with us in the future.
Who's that now?
Dave Cooch. You'll love him. I'm telling you.
Okay.
He's a riot.
All right.
Used to do...
Another guest from Ohio.
Yep, another guy from Ohio.
Okay, cool.
You say that with negativity like it's a bad thing.
Yeah.
No, actually, I like Ohio now.
I was going to say, Jeremy, you're not setting a very good precedent for the rest of your friends.
No, I'm not. Definitely not.
Well, we know there's plenty of transvestites in Ohio that are willing to drive.
And apparently midget porn, too.
There is nothing wrong with midget porn.
I mean...
There's something wrong with that.
Yeah,
that's totally wrong.
I haven't seen one, but it's...
Oh, no, it's great. It's great. Trust me. A fucking thick tongue of theirs. Oh, my God.
Picture Paul now fucking smoking a doobie in his boxes, fucking getting all excited.
Yeah, just like got the fucking curtains closed everywhere, the lights down low.
Yeah, you keep peeking outside every time you hear a noise.
Like you're smoking crack.
Masturbating to pictures of Billy Bob.
The only thing is, you can't ever keep their head centered in frame.
Oh, man.
I heard.
What?
So I heard you can't.
So you heard.
You know, I Googled it once, and I got warned about it. It's illegal. Retarded porn. Oh. Yeah, evidently.
Well, yeah, I would say it's a neglect of a child or whatever it is.
Or
danger in the dark.
Oh, you yeah, would watch something it. Like that.
Well, I just wanted to see what would happen.
Uh-oh, somebody timed out.
A whole bunch of us at work talking about it, right?
Yeah.
And the whole point was how funny it would be. You know what I mean? Like,
well, we lost
go to a seafood restaurant and, like, you get a bib, and it's like a lobster bib, but instead it's like a fucking retard on it. You know what I mean? Because it's like... Before she's even sucking your dick, she's already drooling. So I said, well, you need a bib, like you're going to a seafood restaurant. So the jokes just kept going.
Sorry about that, guys. I got kicked out for a minute.
And then I Googled it just to see what would happen. And yeah, it told me, it gave me a warning.
Yeah, we know you Googled it for a different reason, you sick fuck.
Oh, I would have checked it out.
I'm sure you would have.
Oh. Don't knock it till you try it.
Well, that's the thing. Right. Paul wants to knock it.
Oh, I mean, maybe if you knock it a little too hard, it'll not retarded.
Yeah. So did you get head? Yeah, gigantic.
Oh, man. So what else we got on the subject for tonight? Impeachment died rather quickly.
All right. We got Coventry, the kids there. They settled with CNN for $224 million.
Yes. I want to be one of those kids.
Two different sources that it was $224 million.
I heard it was $271 million.
That's what they were suing for.
Okay. But they settled on 221, you're saying?
24.
Next is the Washington Post 24. And a couple others.
Okay, I saw this...
They're still going after the Washington Post. They're still going after NBC.
NBC, yep.
And others to be disclosed later.
I saw this post on Facebook, and, you know, it wasn't true or anything. It was fake, but I thought it was fucking hysterical. It was about them settling on the lawsuit, and it said in part of a clause on part of the terms that they agreed on that everybody from CNN had to wear a MAGA hat during their broadcast.
No shit.
Yeah, I wish it was true.
Yeah, that's wrong. You would if Brian Stelter ever put a MAGA hat on, He would burst into flame.
I know, he'd stop melting like the Wicked Witch of the West.
Oh, I'd love to see Fredo put one on.
Yeah, it was a good laugh.
Settled because
they were in the wrong. They were admitting they were in the wrong too by settling.
Well, yes.
They don't want to get into their sources
and their fucking their memos, their intercompany memos and shit,
emails
and all that shit, because it would have made them look horrible. I mean,
oh, yeah.
We all know they're
horrible. Obviously had a lot to hide.
Yeah, and the Indian guy. He was, you know, he was a Vietnam vet.
Yeah.
You know what he did? He repaired refrigerators. That's what he did in Vietnam. Here in the United States.
Yeah, he was also known for causing scenes like he did at that.
Right. He's just a cocky son of a bitch trying to sue somebody.
Yeah.
Shut up. If your fucking stupid magic worked, right, we wouldn't own this country. You would. Could have spent less time dancing around a fire like a bunch of Kansas City faggots and invented gunpowder, maybe. Fuck yourself.
So, have you guys ever heard of a show called Hot Ones? It's on YouTube.
No.
All right, so it's this guy, Sean Evans, and he interviews people while eating hot wings. So, you know, they start off with like 2,000 Scovilles and work their way up to 2 million Scovilles. It's very entertaining.
Yeah, that's the pepper scale.
Yeah, exactly. And they had Shia LaBeouf on. I was just watching it earlier. Ooh. And fucking, actually, he was very, very well put together on this interview.
They must have dusted him off well. He's a fucking lunatic.
I've heard he's been doing a lot better recently. He's been on meds, and this kid with Down syndrome he was shooting a movie with actually fucking put him in his place. And
you put your place by a fucking waterhead?
Well, no, because what happened was he was being a douche. He was being a fucking controlling prick, and the kid turns around to him and goes, "Hey," he goes, "You know what? Not for fucking nothing, dude." He goes, "But you've had your shot in Hollywood. This is my first chance at doing anything." He's like, "Why don't you sit the fuck down and give me a shot?" And he said he changed his life, and they've been best friends ever since. But anyways...
Well, he's got somebody he can speak to on his own level.
Well, he was doing hot ones, and he was fucking explaining how him and one of the actors for one of the movies he was shooting, they were fucking starving. They were at this bed and breakfast. And fucking, it was this huge meeting going on. Bunch of fucking rich businessmen. He didn't know who the fuck they were, right? And goes downstairs and fucking nobody's eating like days. He said, he's like, "So I'm in this buffet room with all these rich a-holes, and there's just a bunch of fucking chicken wings everywhere." So he loads this plate of chicken wings and mashed potatoes, right? And these two fucking security guards grab him. They're like, "Who the fuck do you think you are? What are you doing here?" And start, like, interrogating him. He's like, "Dude, I just wanted some chicken." He's like, "Yeah, this is a Bilderberg meeting. Get out." And they threw him out of the fucking building. And fucking George Soros was there. Everybody was there. And he was like, "Man." He was like, "I just wanted some chicken. I'm going to have to start looking over my shoulder for George Soros fucking hiring a hit on me or something."
Yeah,
it was great, but yeah, he just happened to fucking walk in on a Bilderberg meeting.
How the fuck do you just walk into one of them?
I don't know. It was at a bed and breakfast, he said.
Like a shitload of gods?
Yeah, he said there were gods everywhere. He's like, "Oh yeah, I'm a part of this meeting, you know, I'm just getting some food and going back to my room." And, yeah, it was fucking great.
He's a fucking lunatic.
Yeah, he's a nut job, all right.
Remember when he put the camera up? "He will not divide us." Talking about Trump when he got elected. And everyone's fucking getting in the camera and laughing at him and shit.
Okay,
so,
in 2007, 2011, Nancy Pelosi says Obama does not need authorization to use force in Libya.
Of course, it's fine when it's a Democrat.
But Donald Trump needs authorization to use force in Iraq.
Oh, you guys want to know something? Did you guys catch Hannity the other night?
No.
Oh my God. Hannity pulled up like fucking five or six different clips, right? Of fucking Chuck Schumer back in the 90s when Clinton was being impeached. And he was like, oh, you know, this is, you know, the highest offense for a president. You know, we really should be careful about this. It's disgraceful. You know, it will set a bad precedent for future presidents. And, you know, it's scary because, you know, Congress could abuse, you know, the impeachment powers. You know, he's like, we got to really tread carefully here. It's really scary territory.
Yeah, and the funny thing is, he was right. But it was Schumer's making.
Yep.
I'm trying to do it now.
It's going to, the funny thing is, it's going to die in the Senate so hard.
I think
the idea was, it wasn't to get Trump out. They want the Senate. The Democrats want the Senate. They want the Senate and they want the House. And they want to.
It's not going
to
happen. They've already made themselves look like fools.
Yeah,
the American people have had enough. And, you know, most people that don't watch the news all the time, and they see this impeachment here, and they're like, what the fuck is going on?
Yeah, the average slob.
Yeah, exactly.
What is it, this election cycle comes up, is it 31 seats in the House come up for election?
I don't know the exact number.
Oh, is that true?
But I don't think
there's more than that in the House.
Yeah, but I don't think it's even enough to get them, for them to get it back.
What I'm saying is it's 31 seats in the House, not the Senate. Right. 31 seats in the House come open this election cycle.
How many in the Senate?
I don't know. But I believe that if the Republicans were to take, I think it's 16 or 17 of those 31 seats, they would have control of the Senate and the House.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
So the Democrats are running scared.
Well, not only that, though, but five different Democrats just spoke out the other day about walking over the articles of impeachment, Nancy Pelosi stalling, and it's making her look bad.
It's making the Democratic Party has no
credibility, backbone, integrity. The list goes on.
Yeah, she did this, though, in the hopes of getting control over the Senate trial. You know, you have to agree to our rules before we'll send you
over. No, it doesn't work that way.
Right. She forgets the Senate's got power, too. They come up with their own stuff.
Yeah, Mitch McConnell's been laughing in her face.
She wanted to hold the articles impeachment until the election. She wanted to hold it over his head until people were actually getting into the voters' booth and pulling the lever, if you know what I mean.
Oh, I just heard New York just passed a law saying that illegals can now have voter registration.
Yep, because of the driver's licenses and shit.
Right. Yep.
Which the Homeland Security says they're coming down on that. They're looking for a way to stop it. They're
and Ben Carson the other day.
Not right.
Yeah. Right. They, I believe,
have no right to vote in our elections.
They don't have any right to be here, period.
Even legal immigrants don't get to vote.
I personally, my fucking gears, one here should be in office. Even if you're a fucking mayor, nothing, no one. If you weren't born on American soil, you do not get to run for office.
Right.
Do not hold the same values that we do.
That would have saved us a lot of heartache if they pulled that trick with Obama.
Yep, sure would have. Yeah, but not like they'd ever fucking admit to him not being born here.
He was born in Kenya.
His own parents.
I know. Well, no, you see, you have to be born. I'm pretty sure you have to be
American
president, don't you?
American protected.
Oh.
Yeah, he
protectorate.
He got his citizenship by the way Hawaii came a state. That, so that technically made him a naturalized citizen because his family or part of them moved to Hawaii. I get.
Yeah. Yeah, you want to know where they found all of his records, too? England. England has all of his school records saying that he's a foreign exchange student.
Yeah.
Yeah.
His social security number goes back to fucking Connecticut.
Yeah, dead dude in Connecticut that's like 130.
Speaking of which, I know this is
the fucking
somewhat off subject here. But
yeah, go for it.
But since you brought up England, I was watching a documentary on Pluto TV the other day about...
I love Pluto TV.
About the death of Princess Diana.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
And in the tail... I mean, in the like the tail end of this thing, last 7 minutes or so, that this British MI6 agent, former agent, I should say, says it's going to take years before the truth about her death comes out.
Yeah, and he had her killed because she was fucking in love with a Muslim dude.
Yes.
Yeah, and he says, for example, look at the assassination of John Kennedy. It's only recently become our knowledge that the Secret Service agent in the car fired third and fatal shot.
No.
That's what he said at the tail end of that documentary. I was like, what?
I don't believe that. No, it was George Bush Sr. that fired that shot.
It's my favorite film.
He said the Secret Service fired the third and fatal shot.
I don't know about that.
I was like, wait a minute. This was a documentary about Princess Diana. Now I'm over here looking up the assassination of John Kennedy.
Oh, my God.
Literally, at the tail end of that, he said that. I was like, what? Wait a minute.
Ruby killed fucking Oswald.
Oswald was...
It wasn't Oswald. There was an African-American woman that was one of his co-workers that was in the stair with him when the first shot rang out. She saw him walking down the stairs.
Oswald shot Kennedy!
Huh?
Lee Harvey Oswald shot Kennedy.
No.
As a matter of fact, I seen it all. I think it was on MythBusters.
No, I don't think so. Not only that, there's a picture of George Bush Sr. leaning on the depository building that day, minutes after Kennedy was shot, with a big grin on his face. At the time, he was a very low-level agent in the CIA. Later, maybe 2 or 3 years later, maybe 4, I can't remember how much longer, but he was promoted to the head of the CIA after that incident.
I think Trump did it.
I think Trump did it.
I think somebody's doctor in films.
Yeah, see, this is a bad idea to be pitching to an atheist.
Yeah.
Well, you know, they like to say that Lee Harvey Oswald was this, you know, the official story is he tried to defect Russia, he was this great marksman, and blah, 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 blah. The truth is by the time Kennedy was shot, Oswald's marksman skills were considered absolutely horrible.
Okay, then how about this? When Oswald came back from Russia, why was there no press to meet him? Because he was the first one to escape to a foreign country and be extradited back.
Mm-hmm.
There was no press coverage. There was no CIA. There was no Secret Service. There was nobody. It was a setup.
He literally, in the military, Oswald did actually get a really high, you know, rank as far as his accuracy and his marksmanship. But by the time it got around to Kennedy's assassination, his skills were gone, according to him. Because he tried. I do believe he at one point tried to get back in the military.
Quick, if you're good at a gun, you're good at a gun. He was riding a bike, you don't forget.
Very good, Jimmy. I like the analogy on that.
Yeah, it's muscle memory. It's like playing basketball or something.
It's like anything, though. If you don't use it, you lose it.
Yeah, use it or lose it. That is true.
Not really, because once you learn how to do it, you don't forget it.
Yeah.
Practice and repetition.
Right, still, but even if you had to do it 20 years later, you're better shot than yeah. had never done it before.
It's like
that's true. That's definitely true.
It's unpleasant, but you don't go through the motions.
I do not like where this analogy is going. Next!
It's going to get worse.
Oh, God. Oh, man.
Out of that video is watching Kennedy's fucking skull just disappear right onto fucking what's-her-face.
Jackie O.
And she's climbing, like, over the trunk and shit. It's better than when Anakin Skywalker gets his legs. It's definitely better.
You were a sick fuck.
Oh, I looped it.
Oh, man.
It should be my ringtone.
Oh, my God. Remind me not to go through your internet history. I'm going to find snuff videos on there. My God. So, I heard that Nancy Pelosi wrote a letter to Iran apologizing to them for saying that the people of the United States are very sorry about Soleimani. And I believe that is verified.
And she, every vet in the U.S., she's just a piece of shit.
Yeah, she sure is.
You know what I mean? Like I said, the killing U.S. citizens, she don't care about U.S. citizens.
No, she cares
only
about illegals. You owe me a coke.
Yep. Yeah, but at the same time, have you seen the fucking fence over her house on how big it is?
Oh, God, yeah.
No. Oh, my God, she says she cares about them, but... Oh, no. No.
Fucking gigantic brick wall.
Yeah, things like 12 feet tall.
So they can't fucking throw a tent up in the lawn?
It's like as big as the White House fence. Actually, as a matter of fact, when I was in D.C., they had the whole front of the White House shut down. You couldn't even walk on Pennsylvania Avenue because of all the crazies.
It's disgusting.
What, protesters?
They had the whole front of it shut down. You couldn't walk onto it. All the Secret Service members were everywhere.
It's disgusting. They've taken our right to go, you know, go and see the White House.
That's our house. That is the people's house.
It's our house.
Right.
And the fact of the matter, well, actually, they...
Every time some fucking lunatic does something, right? Who gets punished for it? Us!
I say they bring back public hangings again.
Why do we gotta go through all this shit?
Yeah, see, that's the thing. People respond to fear, and I don't mean to sound like a crazy dictator or wrong or immoral, but we need to just stop making public spectacles of these people and start hanging them on TV.
Yes, I agree.
Have like the town square, like they did back in the Western days.
Yeah, no, like a reality show. Do it like a reality show.
Yes, but it's the history of the United States, and if you get wrong, they drop you.
the bottom drops out, fucking, and you just dangle in the air and dance.
What's the saying? A short drop and a quick stop.
Yes, and your neck gets a little longer.
Oh my God, did you guys hear that fucking Trump was calling fucking Adam Schiff on fucking his campaign trail last night?
Oh, pencil neck.
The pencil neck. Oh, I love it.
Got an 8-inch. He buys the smallest shirt you could possibly.
And it's still loose.
And it's still loose.
Oh, man.
Have you seen fucking, Shalhoub do fucking, do him?
Oh, yeah.
Do Schiff. Oh, he's got the eyes, everything perfect.
You have to watch the Gutfeld show to see that.
I love the Greg Gutfeld show.
Shalhoub, yeah, he does the,
Tom Shalhoub.
Yeah, he says, Schiff ordering a pizza, you know, man, it would be him.
Big old bug eyes.
The Rubik's Cube.
Yeah. Proven in the court of law.
Is a mental fucking maniac. He doesn't doesn't even belong in society. No,
shit. These are morons.
And half of the fucking...
How he ever became a lawyer is beyond me. Or a fucking congressman.
Well, because he's in a district where people are retarded.
Yeah. That anybody that's a Democrat.
How the fuck did Nancy Pelosi come? She's got the fucking brain skills, literally, of a child.
She bamboozled along with the mainstream media that they were going to get good medical care and everything, yeah. And did nothing when she got the house.
Well, look at
she
the district.
She did all that to get the house.
Look at the district she represents.
Yeah, I know.
There's poop everywhere on the street.
They literally have apps for San Francisco that say where to avoid because there's so much shit on the sidewalks.
Yeah, I was watching a video the other day. You know, they have the outside, like a restaurant, and then the outside.
Right.
Yeah.
Frontage.
Yeah. Where you can sit and drink right. And eat and stuff. And here's a guy holding on to a pole, fucking shitting right in front of these people. And they're just sitting there accepting that. I'd be like,
I would have gotten up out of my seat and fucking whacked him right in the face.
Oh, yeah, exactly.
Yeah, I would have pushed him right into his own shit.
That's what I mean. I blame the public out there.
Rubbed his nose in it and then hit him with a newspaper.
Oh, my goodness. It's fucking absurd.
They'll let him get away with the crime out there is outrageous. They're going straight into stores and just walking out with anything. If they get caught, it's not a felony, and they can keep doing it as many times.
Yeah, if it's under $1,000, they won't respond.
Right, so they're just walking in there and cleaning the shelves.
CVS opened up a huge mega store there, right?
Yeah.
They're already closing it. They said, no, we're done.
Why would you ever open a shop in L.A.?
400 restaurants closed in San Francisco this year.
Oh, it was San Francisco you're talking about?
Yeah, 400.
Okay. Yep. Yeah. Oh! I'm not sure if this is true or not, but I heard the Green New Deal tax got imposed somewhere in Oregon or Washington State. I don't know if that's true or not, but if you see a city in Washington shrivel up and die, you'll know why.
Oregon, Washington,
California.
They've given. Do you know what?
Massachusetts.
Portland, Oregon gave up on cleaning up the shit off the streets. They gave up. They were like, because they would send in hazmat crews to clean up.
I don't know why they don't send in the fucking National Guard and declare a state of emergency.
Well, then the bums would harass the people cleaning it up. And they said, fuck it, we're not doing this.
Then yeah, you send in the National fucking Guard.
All into one and nationalize it and turn around and say, we'll get taken over your state or whatever. If you people can't take care of the citizens, we're going to do it.
Yeah, martial law.
Absolutely.
Well, not martial law, but I mean, it would officially be martial law.
Yes.
I don't want to fucking die from fucking a disease that was cured 100 years ago.
Exactly. They're just spreading disease by letting people over the border.
And I say you just drop napalm on the fucking cities and be done with it.
These people are Spanish. They emptied out their fucking
jails.
Mental institutions.
Jails and mental institutions.
Exactly, and sent them up here. And that was George Soros' doing.
That's really what needs to happen. There needs to be more mental institutions opened. A lot more, because these people are out of their fucking mind. Nobody has nowhere to go. If you're in jail, when you get out, you end up just fucking reoffending, so that's not helping.
In the 80s, that's when they were emptying them out.
Yeah, under the Clinton. Well, Clinton was the one that fucking...
Yeah, he put the nail in the coffin. Oh, it's just so upsetting seeing fucking society decaying the way it is.
People that can live on their own. And that's the way they live.
Jeremy, you've been awfully quiet. You got anything on your mind?
No.
There seems to be no sign of intelligent life anywhere.
Oh my God, what's that guy from The Simpsons? Sounds just like that.
Yes, Smithers, excellent. Oh man, I am too sober for this shit.
Damn it, Paul.
As he fucking takes a long drag of the doobie just to rub it in my face.
I don't know, since we talked about Princess Diana's death,
sure.
You guys know that it took an hour to get from the scene of the accident to a hospital that was, I think, 1.2 miles away.
Wow, is that right?
They probably shut down the tunnel. That's why they were in a tunnel.
Yeah, they were at the other end of the tunnel. They were exiting the tunnel when the accident happened. They were literally just feet away from exiting the tunnel.
And it obviously wasn't open, otherwise they would have drove.
But from the time it took, from the time they put her into the ambulance, it took them an hour to get to the hospital. And then the driver, Henri Paul, they claimed he was drunk, and that was what caused the accident.
Right.
Ah, however, see, there's more to that story.
Yes. When when his blood, and I say allegedly his blood was tested, they found over a 30% concentration of carbon monoxide in his bloodstream.
Oh.
He wouldn't have been able to even walk to the car, let alone drive that damn thing with that high a concentration of carbon monoxide in his system.
Yeah. Yeah, he'd be fucking, he would be completely immobilized.
Yeah, he would be non-functional. In other words, that's not what happened. He was not drunk. And like all likelihood, if his blood tested that high for carbon monoxide, it was after the accident, or his sample was switched.
Yeah, he was scopolamined.
Yeah. Because there's just no way it was in his system before the accident, because he wouldn't have been able to move.
You think that's something that the MI could, MI5 or whoever they are?
MI6. Yeah, they were, in all likelihood, if this was an assassination attempt on her, it was them that carried it out.
You know, that reminds me of the Billy Shear thing.
MI5, back in the 60s. I don't know when they went to, what is it, MI6? I don't know when they changed that.
They also claim she was pregnant at the time of the accident.
Yeah, by that guy. Yeah, did the Muslim die too, or just her?
Everybody in the car died.
Everybody.
Huh.
I mean, if you seen pictures of the car, it's a miracle anybody had a heartbeat coming out of that thing.
Me mom died. Did they tell you about that, Megan? Me mom died.
Yeah.
She was blowing an Arab guy. She's driving through a tunnel, don't you know?
And her neck broke.
Yeah, when we found her, his dick was still in her mouth.
Must have bit it off with my rosacea cheeks. And that stiff wave.
Oh my God. We are definitely all on a list somewhere.
Fuck the royal family. You don't even pay fucking taxes.
Well, Prince Harry and Meghan do now.
Yes!
They both stepped away.
Yeah, I guess she had a private business deal going on, too, that she had signed that she didn't mention when she got married. She had planned on running from the royal family the whole fucking time. You yeah. wanted nothing to do with that.
Well, I don't blame her.
I don't either. Smart woman.
She's probably going to end up killing herself in a few months.
Sure. Let's go with that.
The British royal family will hire Hillary Clinton to get a hitman for her. Hold on a second.
Okay.
What's that now?
I gotta set up for the next hour after we're done. Otherwise, we can go 2 hours. It's open. I just gotta fill it in.
If you guys want to, by all means, but I got my lady friend in the other room and she'll kill me.
Yeah, so there you go. And no, I don't feel like doing it.
Yeah, there's really, there's not like a shitload of stuff going on in politics right now, so.
No, nothing interesting anyway.
How about yes. I ran fucking bulldoze in the,
Oh, yeah, the plane site.
Yeah.
Oh, my goodness. And they refused to hand over the fucking black box, too.
Well, from what I understand, Iran allegedly claims that they accidentally shot it down.
Yeah.
Thought it was a B-52.
Well, you know what? Not for nothing, but that pilot should have stayed way the fuck out of where they were flying. That's a war zone. A
danger zone.
Yeah, exactly. That was just negligent of the pilot.
Well, it was after
takeoff. They were taking off when it was shot down.
From Ukraine?
That's the way this the article I read earlier said they were. It was
no. I don't think
they were shot down.
Yes, but I believe they were in a no-fly zone.
Well, it depends on were they leaving Iran to go home or were they coming in. You know what I'm saying?
That I don't know.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, you got a good point there. You know, see, my understanding was they weren't in Iran. I thought they were coming in from another country.
Oh, no. Well, it was right outside of Tehran.
Oh. Oh.
Yeah.
Yeah, that makes things a lot different.
And what do you...
Boeing said we want the black boxes back.
And they said, fuck you.
By the plane, right? The black boxes are owned by Boeing.
Right.
So even if the plane crashes, right, they get the black boxes back. They disseminate the information that's on it because they built it.
Right, yeah, it's their encryption.
What do you guys think about the theory that Iran launching all those missiles into Iraq was a setup?
Oh, my God. We knew about it. We got everybody out, and they missed every single fucking target.
And they threw toasters, and they hit gold wagons.
They did it just to flex their muscles and say to their people, oh, we retaliated. It's like you guys didn't fucking retaliate.
Well, actually, there's people out there that believe that Iran actually told us they were going to do it so we could get our people out of there.
Yeah,
it was an effort.
It was a propaganda effort.
It was an effort on Iran's part to save face and look like they retaliated at the same time without us attacking them.
Right. Jeremy, I believe you're correct on that. I think that makes the most sense. Because how do you miss every single fucking target with 12 ballistic missiles? How? Were you fucking, what's his face from fucking Spaceballs? I'm sorry, sir, I'm trying my best.
This guy with the
cross eyes.
Crossed eyes. I don't believe this. This whole ship's full of assholes.
I said across your nose, not up it. Oh, my goodness.
What's the matter, Colonel Sanders? Chicken?
Nobody calls me chicken.
That movie was hilarious.
Yeah, the ships!
It's too bad John Candy's still not around, you know, because they could make a sequel for that.
Oh, my goodness. I fucking wish they would.
They won't without him. That's probably the
only one. Oh, I know. It's not the same. It would not be the same.
Joan Rivers was awesome in it.
Yes.
I love Joan Rivers.
I'm a Druish princess. Great. That's just what we need around here.
Yeah. And then they show the picture of her with her original nose.
Yes.
No, not the nose. Schwartz is as big as mine.
Yeah. Rick Moranis was so fucking great in that. So fucking great.
Yeah, no, the part where they're in the desert looking for him. He looks at those two black guys. If you found anything, we ain't found shit.
Yeah, they got the pick.
Because they were combing the desert. And all the white guys had combs. And the fucking two black guys had a pick.
Hey, do you think we're taking his orders a little too literally? No, you moron. He told us to comb the desert. What do you think we're doing?
I like when fucking Rick Moranis is talking to fucking, oh my God. Don't you ever put that mask down in front of me.
Yeah, fucking Mel Brooks.
God, is Mel Brooks even still alive?
Yeah. Yeah, he's like 87 or something like that.
Oh, they need to make another movie before he passes. He's like a comedy genius.
When I was a kid.
Yeah, I know.
76, I was 11.
He was in his 60s back in the 80s, so you know what I mean?
Yeah. Blazing Saddles come out in 76. I was 11.
He is 93 years old.
Oh!
How old?
93.
Yeah, there you go.
He's ripe.
He's probably shitting on himself right now, and that's why he doesn't make any more movies. He's loading his diaper as we speak.
Hey, you never know. Well, then again, with all that clean air he was huffing, he might be.
Jesus Christ, he made 45 films?
Oh, yeah. He made tons of fucking...
Blazing Saddles, I gotta watch that one. I ain't seen that one in forever. Young Frankensteins.
He did the Get Smart, too, didn't he?
Baseballs.
Get Smart with, Buck Henry.
The producers?
Remember Buck Henry?
He wrote them.
Him and Buck Henry. Remember, he was on Saturday Night Live all the time. Yeah, he was the creepy uncle.
Right. Oh, have you guys caught The Mandalorian yet?
No,
one episode.
I do have Disney.
Oh yeah, I gotta come to your house and set it up for you, right.
Yeah.
Fucking, yeah, check it out. It's fucking awesome. I just finished it.
And because Disney was talking about doing a movie of The Mandalorian, and everyone's like, no, leave it alone.
Yeah.
The people that are actually doing The Mandalorian know Star Wars.
Oh, it's fucking phenomenal. I love it.
Oh.
And it's post-Empire, too. I believe it's after the sixth movie.
Yeah, well, it's in the same time frame. It's with
Right. It's like the precursor to the New Republic, because, everybody's still in shambles. You just see fucking stormtrooper helmets fucking littered everywhere.
I'm dying to see Knights of the Old Republic.
Oh my God, I can't wait. They've been trying to push for Keanu Reeves to be Reverend for so fucking long.
He wants to do it.
Oh, does he?
Yes.
Ooh. Keanu Reeves would play a great Reverend. Oh my God.
SpongeBob fucking movie.
Yeah, he's also doing The Matrix. He's doing John Wick 4. He's doing a new Constantine.
Bill and Ted.
New Bill and Ted. They want to put him in the Marvel Universe now. He said he might be interested in that. Yeah, he's got a lot on his plate right now.
I'd love him to see him in the Knights of the Old Republic.
That would be badass. I would go see that.
thousand.
Well, he would make a great Jedi.
I'd like to see it when the Jedi were at their best. You know what I mean?
Yeah, at their peak.
Because by the time you get to the sequels and the prequels, the Jedi are on the downslide.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. It's like the end of the Jedi by the time you get to even the first movie. When you get to The Phantom Menace, they're all falling apart.
Exactly. They're already on the downslide.
Yeah, I want to see them during their golden age.
Exactly.
And I want to see what it would be like with the War of the Sith. Oh, that would be crazy.
I'm looking forward to seeing the Obi-Wan fucking series.
Oh, yeah, fucking, what's-his-face is coming back, too, to do it, Ewan McGregor. Yes. They said they've had that in the works forever.
And he wasn't allowed to talk about it until that Disney Plus came out.
Yeah, and he was saying, he was like, man, he goes, by the time this series comes to fruition, I'm going to start looking like the original Ben Kenobi.
Yeah, the old man.
Yeah. But, yeah, the fucking...
River Kwai.
Yes.
They're also talking about getting back Mace Windu.
Yeah, I heard about that. Who cares?
Even George Lucas said that could have survived that. You know, they're trying to think of a way to bring him back. I could tell by the way it's all going.
Yeah, they'll probably have him in, like, fucking the Knights of the Old... No, that's too set too far back. I didn't really care for Mace Windu's...
Like Coruscant, right? Before it was a total city.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? The whole planet.
Yeah.
And shit like that. That's what I like to see. How it got to where it is.
Well, they said they got a lot of stuff in the works. I'm sure during the Old Republic we'll probably see them colonizing planets and all sorts of good shit.
Okay, this is an opinion thing. Out of all of the Star Wars movies from then all the way up to now, which one is the worst?
The worst?
The Phantom Menace.
Yeah, either the Phantom Menace or the Clone Wars.
No, Clone Wars was a good movie.
It was all right.
The Force Awakens.
Yeah,
my opinion, Solo.
Ah, Solo. I heard Solo was horrible.
Gosh, I tried to... I got the movie. I got the disc. Tried to watch it 3 times. Got about 15, 20.
I think one of the best ones that they've made in a long time was Rogue One. Rogue One was fucking awesome.
Was good,
yeah. Movie. Yeah, Rogue One was good. Yeah. I liked it.
I think that was on par with the originals, in my opinion. It felt like a Star Wars movie.
What was the one?
Which one are you talking about?
What's her name? Carrie Fisher. Yeah. When she floats back in.
That was
The Last Jedi.
The Last Jedi. What a hunk of shit.
I watched it. I didn't like it.
Hunk of shit. I'm looking at him like, it looks like Disney. Like,
And then you see Luke Skywalker walk out and you go, oh my god, it's Chris Fischoni.
Yeah. Sucking on a fucking tit and getting some green milk.
Milk, yeah. Yeah, staff and all. No, in all seriousness, though, we love Chris.
Yeah, Chris is a great guy. But yeah, it definitely looked like him.
Yeah, sure did.
Working for the TSA.
Oh, man.
They're going to burn Star Wars out is what they're going to do.
Not if they do the Old Republic. I think the Old Republic, I have hope for those movies.
Me too.
There's what, been three movies in 4 years or whatever, or five?
Yeah, they've been saturating the
It's a little too much.
And now the Mandalorian, which actually is what I did see of it, is pretty good.
Yeah, it's phenomenal. Yeah, I like the actor that plays the Mandalorian. He's a badass.
I don't want
to. Lucas is just throwing a fucking suit the works of everything. He is so sick of how they've taken his vision.
Well, George Lucas actually sits in and helps write the movies. He has bearing in what goes into the movies.
No. He wasn't even invited to the fucking, the last movie, to the
premiere.
That's not what I heard. I heard him and J.J. Abrams are very close, and they had a good relationship.
The same guy that destroyed Star Trek.
Yeah, J.J. Abrams bombed on Star Trek. It was too much of a rehash of older films.
Yeah. The first one was good.
And then when
The Wrath of Khan lacked luster. They rushed that too much.
Then when he did the Star Wars, I'm like, this is just like all three of the first original films in one film.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The droids got the fucking information.
Yeah. The planets, the Death Star. They got to get the plans to destroy it.
Lesson from the Empire and went after the droid first.
no shit.
All right, say goodnight to the troops.
Yes, thank you. Thank you for everyone here and overseas serving with us.
Anybody else? We got 5 seconds.
On a side note, Paul blows goats. Bye.
Alright.
Faggot.
Have a good night, everyone.
Later, guys.
I was foolish. I was angry. I was fun. I was charming. I was lucky. Tell me how.